Hello everyone, Dennis here for the Cousin Smash. Today I'm going to show you my collection of 5-inch CRT TVs and also included two tablets. The reason I included two tablets is because they're not cell phones and I still would be able to watch the TV on there with some several applications. In the right internet signal, I would be able to live stream and follow the news or, for example, History Channel. So to start with, this is my Crown portable TV with FM, AM, 2-band radio and AC battery. It's a transistor made in Japan. It's kind of very badly damaged, but it's still nice. From who I bought it from, probably knew me because he said, "Do not smash it," and I was like, "Huh?" I actually said, "I will not do that." You know, that's like a little rusty. You can put some big batteries in there. Antenna, yeah, perhaps. Extra antenna port for TV. 12 volt DC, a normal AC. I've never seen a plug like that. Yeah, the holes. Oh, that's shit. Nasty. Rusty, I mean. All that stuff is on there. I'm not sure where it's made in. Thought it could be here on the back, but I don't fucking believe it. It's not even listing when it's made. Oh, German. Well, oh, here we go. So we're having a look around on this unit here, and on this side it has a switch for TV and whatever, I'm not sure. Never really using that. I suppose it's just for analog TV, which the single has been shut down for a while. The tuner for the, I think this is for the TV because it's VH7 UHF. Yeah, this tuner. The tuner for the radio. The power button is kind of broken. Just have to pull it back out like that. Volume button, it's kind of stuck in the switch of the thing you're using, switch of the combo you're using right now, radio or TV, and the bands. I'm not sure what that plug is for, and this is for headphones, I suggest. So that's the Crown. Here is the Konic. It's a triple combo. It has radio, TV and cassette recorder. Microphone in there as well, so I suggest you can actually bring up your own tapes, because it's recording, you can start screaming in the microphone. Excuse me. So I'm going to bring this one forward. So just like the other one, just like all of them by the way, our 5-inch displays. This one has also got the UHF and the VHF tuner for TV, AM and FM tuner for the radio. You can see. Oh, fuck. That's not right. There we go. Kind of broken there. Volume. Oh, I think you need some pot spray for that. Some contact spray. Selector of your use. Tape deck. A radio and TV. AM. FM. And an off switch.
Ahem.
and dust particles. So on the top we have a tape deck. So the antenna on this one is broken. Also the controls for the display. This is kind of messed up, I'm not sure why. Also a switch for what band you're using. A Rock Band. There's not a lot of information listed on the back. Nothing actually, just some cooling particles. On the top is a speaker, I just found out. Also on that one, forgot to mention that, probably not even important. Where the speaker is located, maybe for one who was having one of these and wants to repair them, it could be. Here you could put your DIN, cool. Earphone and microphone. AC adapter and DC adapter. AC, DC. Let's do this. On the bottom here we have some basic information. Also it does not list when it was built. Caution, to prevent electric shock, do not touch the surface. Now here is the battery door. You can put the batteries in there for fucking sake, how obvious is that? For Christ's sake, isn't that obvious? That was this one as well. Okay, I don't think I have to mention anything else except for that it just dropped a little bit. I would be so fucking pissed if this one, if these break. Seriously. So next is this, well, it's not really a TV, but it's a TV though, it's wire. It's a monitor that allows you to watch your camera here. You have a wireless camera. It comes with this one. It wasn't included, so I have it for free. You have this antenna to locate the camera, goes through the walls. It's kind of damaged, but also in this one it looks pretty nice still. On the off button, switch for the volume. I don't know where the speaker's located, but somewhere on the sides. AC input kind of loosened here. Channel. This is an output, so you can't plug it onto your PS3 or anything. And also the holds. So this one is not really luxury or anything, it's just pretty simple. Has not got an antenna for a TV tuner, just for your home protection camera. Okay, so this one is actually the first small TV I actually bought. I had everything included until my mom threw everything away except for some cables and stuff, which I really, really pissed off about. Oh, there's a tuner here. Band, power, volume, antenna. I think that has an external antenna input. Whoop. Headphone input, AC input, DC input, and brightness and contrast. One of the things I'm concerned about is the fact that this TV shuts itself down after a couple of minutes. It can be on for 15 minutes and it just automatically shuts down. Not sure why. Doesn't have radio included into it, so these older ones are more luxury. And I think they're from boats. Also, they look like they were made after World War II, because they're looking very vintage. This one here I have from Lawrence, Digila One. And this one is quite luxury. It has a lot of features, but the inside the tuner is broken. The CRT TV itself is 5 inch, just like the others. It could be a little bigger. Nah, it's just 5 inch. Volume. TV. Radio. What is that? Off. Okay. Let's switch. Tuner. Or actually the setting of your tuner. On the back we have some interesting information. By the way, I forgot to mention about this one. It has also got the ability to put batteries in there. But because it's not so simple. Because it's not a very interesting thing. I did not mention it. But if you really wanted to know that, here's your information. Here's the AC in. External antenna in. Input for the video. Earphone. And the settings. I'm not sure what this is for. It's also a switch. And now there's a speaker right there. Now we're going to my most recent buy. I made a video of. This one is a AudioSonic. Radio. CD. TV player. And I think it's impressive. In the fact that actually they were able to build this, I still haven't cleaned it up, so it looks really nasty on you. And it really is. Actually, I think I'm going to clean it after this video. The tuner. Oh, nasty fucking fuck. Jesus. Another switch for your bands of the radio. Volume, and balance, or tone, that's a tone. On the front here, play, pause, stop, skip, mode, batteries. Why do I forget to mention that? Because it's not important perhaps, but still. Tuner display. 5 inch CRT power switch. Oh, I actually heard something turn on there. Weird. Band function. Headphones. 2 speakers which have pretty much bass in it on the side. With a gasket. CD player. Antenna, a handle. This is so weird. On the back here, it's very so fucking nasty, man. Oh, damn it. Whoa. Okay, here's the DC in or AC in? AC in. This is the, I suggest the your band as well. The PAL for Europe, SACAM for I don't know what. Antenna. I never pulled that out before. Yeah, I think you can put your TV on here as well if you have analog TV still. I mean cable. DC. And as usual, the screen settings. I don't think on the side is anything interesting. This time I'll mention it straight. You can put so fucking many batteries in there as you want. It won't work if you put less in there. Let's see, how many go in there? 9 batteries. Oh gosh. And they're out of power in no time, believe me. Turn around. That's a song as well. Turn around. I don't care. Here come my tablets. Actually not mine, but still. This is a 7 inch Android 4.0 tablet, which is from audio. Now what is it? Empire. And a iPad 1. I look like a guy from Ancient Aliens, don't I? Okay, so 50 minutes. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked it, but I'm still going to go around the tablets. If you don't want to see those, it's just not in this video. You just go ahead. If you would like to see a look around on these, stay on tune. So on the bottom of the tablet, or actually the right side of the tablet, audio, headphones, microphone, USB/charger input, a micro SD speaker, screw. And here we have a on and off button, volume rocker, home button. For some reason the on-screen home button doesn't always respond. Case is kind of broken, I don't know how that happened. On the top there's nothing really, and on the bottom isn't really anything either. But here comes the magic. There is a possibility that this tablet is 3G, but I'm not sure, because it has the ability for that for some reason. It seems to be a come on, focus. There's another bed microphone in the back. Oh, it's a cooling system, I'm not sure. Here's a gasket for something. Maybe to put your 3G card in there. I suggest this is a part where the heat of the tablet comes from. I don't know why they put a friggin' pooch with it, a fucking case, if it's just there for cooling. Fucking logic sometimes. I'm just going to snap it in there, I don't care. Well, then we go to the iPad 1, perhaps anything. But everybody has watched it, has ever seen a review of this. So, the iPad 1. It's classic, it's big, and it's awesome. Only that it's shutting down its friggin' applications after a failed after jailbreak recovery. I'm not sure, but I think it's broken. I'll pull it out so we can get a look around on the tablet itself, which I'm not going to spend a lot of time on, because like I said, everybody has probably seen a review of this. It's a 10-inch display, it's friggin' heavy. Adam and Eve logo here, fucking Illuminati Apple. A giant huge ass dent in the back. Probably I should have slapped it less, Jesus. That's not right. iPad 16 gig, designed by Apple. Assembled in China. Copyright. And like I said, a whole shitload of dance.